20 past 8. We're at little deserted town of Orbost. Driven about 5 hours from Canberra, left about 1:30, 2 o'clock. Lovely drive, Cooma, had a pie, red bow. And down the Snowy Mountains Highway, down to Bombala, where we saw the lunar eclipse, or solar eclipse, I think. That's my little headlamp shining. I'm just looking for a Macca's for dinner at 8:30 before we go on to Bairnsdale. Everybody else is camped at Bairnsdale. The nearest Macca's is down at the lakes. There you go, the headlight lights it up. Find a nice park in Orbost before we head off now to Bairnsdale at 8:45. No Macca's, nothing in town here. It'll be a detour down to the lake's entrance. Not worth the effort. So we went to the wrong caravan park. It's 1-star rating. And now we've found the NRMA Big Four. And we've got the heater on down there. We've got the microwave plugged in, a new microwave. Our first heating of the new microwave.
What was that?
Well, it's 20 to 9 and they're starting to meet and greet and planning the trip. And Mary's gonna have a shower. About where people are gonna ride from, which is over there across near the bridge, is the start of the bike ride and the bike trail. Photo time. Now we're just wondering whether the bin man's going to come. We'll just check. Well, the recycling man hasn't been yet. We're parked in the side street. They're all gathering to the fray. Yep. There's the signal. See the signal? It's all go. They're off. You got the flag, the signal up there. There's even a compressor that doesn't work. Well, we drove all around Bairnsdale looking for petrol and coffee at Macca's. What's the milk at the Aldi for the first time ever, and then we ended up at a petrol servo, Lapco, which was half a AGA. Just along here is a guy coming along in a boat. This is the road down to Painesville. We followed the Painesville high truck detour. And met a large motorboat launch being towed along the road. There goes another fisherman heading off down to the lake's entrance. Down there somewhere. Well, this is part of Painesville. And there's where the rich and famous come to die and retire. And a lot of retirement homes back up there. And there's a fancy bridge crossing this marina. You may get a shot of it on the way back.
his own little jetty. The end of King Road, Bairnsdale, where the fishermen come. No crowds here on Friday. That's Lake King out there. Mm-hmm. We might go to Meetung for some reason for dinner.
No, we're not.
Don't need to now.
Mm.
Well, that's the bike route, that's the old railway line. And the cyclists are on their way up to Bruthen up there. And then they ride along next day to Nowa Nowa. And then to Orbost.
You know as much about this as I do. Peregrine falcons live here.
Tree for
a nesting tree.
Yeah. Well, I don't know, I can't see any nest.
No. Looking across to Bairnsdale and Raymond Island.
Well, these places will be a bit threatened.
Oh yeah, global warming is going to flood this out. The whole lot of this will all disappear.
Yeah.
bus wouldn't come down here. All these little fishing spots. You can park your car for the weekend.
Bet you can't. Rangers would be out here.
Patrolling. Missing the net. Wondering if that's the kangaroo grass that's dying out. I'll head out of the rainforest and stuff and up to Bairnsdale. The traffic stopped. Skateboard ramp, that's the main Omeo road. And we're just coming in the back of Bruthen. The rail trail's up there. There's the pub. What is it? The playground. We're across the Tambo River, past the pub. This is a caravan park. Let's see whether we can squeeze in somewhere. We had a good night at the Bruthen pub and dinner and all, and it was cold and frosty this morning, and we've toured around a bizarre junk shop and bought lots of junk, and we went to the local brewery, the Bull Ant Brewery over there, had coffee and relaxed and bought some brew, what was it called? They had pilsners and pale ales and you name it. And now we're heading off for a spot for lunch. This is the highway. All the trucks go by. Well, this is part of the rail trail. We've come down here in Angla. And somewhere is a gas pipeline. We just had our pastry and what's the name? Had a braised type tart. And there's the rail trail coming up from Bruthen, and the Baron's car. There he's ridden back up to Nowa. I'm gonna come back and get the car. There's thousands of mosquitoes, and that's a road down to the coast. They rode up past there a couple of hours ago. They're probably at Nowa Nowa. It's a nice, smooth, good ride. It's fairly level from here. There's a few climbs up to this point. So we came down 4.3 from the Highway 602 to the north. So they've ridden from this morning. From Bruthen.
It's only 14k from here. So it's an easy day's ride. Well, along here is the abandoned railway station for Kowloon. Everybody's collecting their cup of teas.
Hello. Well, we had a pasty too. Did you get it from the Bruthen bakery?
Yeah.
We're heading south, southish down to the Prince's Highway through the state forests. Every man, his dog out here is getting firewood. Saturday. After lunch, how about one? Lots of stringy bark and blackwood. Passing through the odd forest coop. There's a watering point there. I just crossed over Blackfellow's Road. Scriven it with an I on the map. That's going across country around. Now we drove up here then down to the rail trail. We're following this one down now, down to the highway, lake's entrance. There's Scrivener Road. Chris and Alison were doing this detour.
Well, they've just done that alternate trail, I think.
They're doing an alternate trail off Scrivener. Sitting in the car looking at Guru maps to see where we are. 2k further east is the way across to that island. We dined here 2015 when we came down to buy Angler. We've driven along west a little bit. Just pull into a motel while we get some money from the hole in the wall. This is coming down to Lake Bunga, where the first oil seepage was. In 1924, a guy found the ebullition of the gas coming up in the lake. He didn't realize 20 kilometers offshore was the rest of the oil. And somewhere down here is a reproduction oil rig commemorating There's a jetty. Now the oil rig's further back near the highway. We should have turned left immediately after we turned down this road to here. What a peaceful enough said.
near the southern south west corner of 90 Mile Beach. Well, this is what retirement is all about. And the oil rigs are off there, 20k or so. Just heading down the old Bunga Road to the oil site. There it is. This is the one that's in Offbeat Australia. How about that?
Look, I'm on the tractor. They're usually got, you know, laser thingos and CD players and everything, and it's all, they just sort of sit there and listen to the radio or whatever they do, and it's really smooth and modern and stuff, but graders still shake all the time, eh?
Yeah, they sort of do. It's sort of a trade where you can make it as hard on yourself as you're not, and you were saying there with tractor drivers, even in the graders and that now, we're running GPS. They're actually built for a lot of these young people and that today that have played PlayStations and that all their lives. They've got button controls and all sorts of stuff now, which us older blokes sort of struggle with to start with, but once you get used to them, they're fantastic.
Sun's coming up.
GPS, and what the clients do is they run a file, which is the design, and where you put everything into levels in design, you bring it up to subgrade in a different way.
There's a tie between your heart and mine, and it's grown so strong over time. Bound together wherever we try.
The view from my pillow. After 8 a.m. just listening to Macca, with people phoning in from all over Australia.
But there's a lot of water dripping off the trees.
Yeah.
How will you get to them?
Isn't it amazing? I was just going to say, when you don't travel for a little while, like a year, and then all of a sudden you go back out, like we went to Maryworth, and we drove home, and just apart from
each other, we said we could live here, you know, because they made us so welcome.
They're lovely, aren't they?
Yeah, nice. Country towns, there's nothing like it.
I don't think we'll live here.
Rod and Gina will be here for a little while.
that I notice is everywhere, especially in the loos, well, the gents anyway. It's 5 to 9 a.m. Just go and check out the camp kitchen. It's a lovely little rustic caravan park. They've spent some effort on lighting stands, and the power is safe. We used our amphibian last night, so that checked the power. And this is the office over there. And here's the camp kitchen. And there are even campers in a little tent on the frosty grass. We're not riding a bike, we're following 8 other people who are riding their bikes.
Oh, okay.
And we're doing the scenic tour.
Ah.
We're just following along as a, not in a support role at all, but just watching and photographing. Oh, there's the old bridge there, is it?
No, oh, what's well, that it, one? Is a, it is a bridge.
The railway?
It's sort of not the really old one.
Oh, okay.
Along the trail a bit, there is, oh, I'm just trying to think now. I'm sort of a bit confused. There are a few railway bridges. There is a bridge.
What's that mean?
Oh, that'd be
that
a bit
code?
Of a dance.
Is that code for something?
He's happy when he does that.
See, now, here you go. Look.
Just having a nice little digestive.
They're magnificent birds, aren't they? I just love them. We used to have quite a lot, and in Canberra, because everything's in Canberra, parrots.
Let's see, it's 14 years old.
We had about 40 of them that used to visit, and they'd come in a mob, but there were a few that, you know, just came sort of the 8 or 10 at the time. But they'd go around the back, kitchen windows out the backyard, and they'd threaten to take, they used to take their clothes pegs off their line.
And that's the Nowa Nowa Caravan Park. Nowa Nowa is Aboriginal for mingling waters. It's the salt water from the ocean that mingles with the fresh water here. But sometimes it's a bit perched at the moment. It may not be open from time to time. I can't believe the altitude then. I thought we climbed up it. Climbed up Fair K. And there's the Trestle Bridge is our next stop. And this is a rail trail ramble near the local RSL, I think. We'll go over here and see one of the carvings that line the boardwalk at Lake's entrance. They're cementing and crushing and rolling the trail. This is the back of the caravan park. And that's the office where we were. We're just saying cheerio to Banjo. And that's where we were 10 minutes ago, or an hour ago. Cooking the porridge. We've done a little circle of 400 meters. bridge from the train from Bairnsdale to Orbost. And that's the back of the caravan park. Now we'll head down to the trestle. Is that a tree or a vine?
But round here it's got green leaves and
that's the tree.
Yeah. I don't know that it's it might have a bit of a variegated thing on it.
Have taken 5 months. It's a very unsatisfactory display board here. It's the bridge that fell down, the train that fell off, it was at Stony Creek, which is this one, but one of the guys working there said it was the other one. And they've got a mile peg here, which is a 205. And the guy in his letter says it was on the 210. Morning, we've got a derailment on the 210 bridge between Bruthen and Nowa Nowa, the highest wooden bridge. Well, it's this one, and they've got a 205.
They found a 205 mile peg, so they've put that
up there. The 210 one's gone missing.
Yeah.
Well, this is the Stony Creek Trestle Bridge. You've got trestle steps everywhere as well. It's got some steel girders up there. Not sure why they didn't use steel for the pylons. Looks like a bit of wind throw here. I have to ask Graham why the pairs of trestles aren't connected. There's terrible, stinky, unclean loos. I have to get onto Vic Rail or whoever looks after it. There's a bike trail, a rail trail coming down there. nice going down. It's not a bad viewpoint here. Well, we had dinner with the mob, the 10 of us, in a little Thai restaurant in town, the main street of Orbost, which was very pleasant. We found it through a little brochure at the motel they were staying at. Most of the cooks had left town, or they were having cancer operations, or they were living on the job keeper, so they didn't think it was worth going back to work, according to the lady at the motel hotel. We're just gonna dump here from the Orbost Caravan Park and go down to the coast. Well, we had an hour's wander in the museum at Orbost and saw all the pumpkins that's mentioned in Offbeat Australia, and saw the pumpkin photos, quite a few of them floating on the river. And this is good dairy country along here. They've been pruning the river trees all along. It's been 40k an hour off and on, cows and potty calves everywhere. Cows been milked this morning. We're just leaving the river now. We're going inland a bit. I forgot to mention that was a mighty snowy river. Snowy meets the ocean. Want to throw in a sinker? Rain. There's the Murray and snowy mouth. This was all burnt out in the fires, and they're spending $20 million on infrastructure, new barbecues, tables and chairs, campgrounds. So we'll have to come back here, Cape Conran, and camp in any number of camp spots along here, with new loos and all. All new, lovely, long drop or short drop loos. To come back in the sunset time. All the ace canoers can come down here with their kayaks, look at that. Go up the river or in the surf. It's even COVID safe down here. lovely snorkeling. All the new tables and chairs, and look at the geology over there. They even got wheelchair access down to the beach. Look at that, Harley. How's that? Must have been a scary place to be during the fires. We'd have to go down onto the beach for shelter. Shoot them, I suppose. Cooma 517. Looks like Macca's is closed. I think this might be the end of our little 4 or 5 day trip. And then it's home now, back to Canberra.